So, any objections from the other resource persons here? Hearing none, the House Bill number 6581, authored by Congressman Edwin Olivares, is hereby approved, and the same will be submitted to the plenary subject to a technical working group.
Thank you very much, Your Honor. On behalf of Congressman Edwin Olivares, we are so thankful to the committee, Your Honor. Thank you very much.
For House Bill 6580, Congressman Loyola, if you would want to have an introductory statement before we ask the Supreme Court Administrator to speak concerning 6581, creating two additional branches of the Regional Trial Court in the 4th Judicial Region to be stationed in the municipality of Silang, province of Cavite, and appropriating funds, therefore. Congressman Loyola, you have the floor.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. Mr. Chairman, honorable members of this esteemed committee, distinguished guests, good morning po. First, on behalf of the people of Carmona, allow me to express our deepest gratitude to the Senator Francis Tolentino and to the rest of the members of the Senate under the 19th Congress headed by Senate President Mick Zubiri for the passage of Republic Act number 11683 and Republic Act 11938 in our journey to the cityhood, in our long and thorny journey to the cityhood of Carmona. On July 8th, Mr. Chairman, we will be holding our plebiscite to pave the way for the cityhood of Carmona. Maraming salamat po, and would like also to acknowledge, to express our gratitude to former Senator Ping Lacson. Again, I would like to express our gratitude to the esteemed committee and Chairman Senator Francis Tolentino for including in today's agenda another significant measure for the 5th District of Cavite, House Bill number 6580, an act creating two regional trial courts in the province of Cavite under the 4th Judicial Region to be stationed in Silang, Cavite. Mr. Chairman, Silang is a first-class municipality in the province of Cavite with a population of more or less 300,000 and a land area of around 18,000 hectares. It is the home of many factories, an agricultural area, and a favorite vacation place for the Metro Manila. At present, there is no existing court, a regional trial court in the municipality of Silang. The cases emanating from Silang is being filed and tried in the regional trial court of the progressive city of Tagaytay, the hometown of our honorable chairman. The regional trial courts in Tagaytay also covered other municipalities like the municipality of Marugondon, Alfonso, Bailen, and Magallanes, and Silang. The creation of two RTC branches in the municipality of Silang is of utmost importance as it will bring justice accessible and available to the people of Silang. In view of the foregoing, I respectfully move for the immediate passage of this bill. Thank you, Mr. Chairman.
Thank you, Congressman Loyola. Before we ask the court administrator to give a statement, the chair recalls, Your Honor, a hearing conducted by this committee months ago wherein the honorable court administrator promised to send this committee a draft bill to assist this committee concerning the provision of tax incentives for those that would lease out private structures to the judiciary. May we know from Your Honor's office, when can this committee receive a copy of said position paper?
Yes, good morning, Your Honor, the Honorable Chairperson of the Committee on Justice and Human Rights at Senator Francis Tolentino, and of course, everyone present. Your Honor, actually, right after that hearing, I tasked already our legal office to prepare or draft that particular bill as suggested by Your Honors. I will just check. I know that there, I saw already the draft, Your Honor. I don't know if it was already communicated to the committee. If not, then I will have it communicated already.
Thank you, Justice. May we ask the ComSec if you receive any copy, not yet. So let the records reflect that the committee is still awaiting for a copy of that draft bill. The reason why I raised that, members of the committee as well as resource persons here, is that there are instances wherein LGUs are not yet ready to provide adequate structures and physical spaces. So that's why if there is a vacant or if there is a private owner of a structure willing to lease out, there should be an accompanying tax incentive, perhaps 50%, 60%, because this would enable the judiciary to function immediately if we create new courts. So with assurance coming from the court administrator, we await that draft bill. Any comment, Your Honor, relative to the proposed measure that would create two additional salas for the RTC, but let us lay the premises outright. For an RTC, I have here several copies of data coming from the Supreme Court. For an RTC, there should be at least 500 cases lodged within a sala of RTC. For a law, first level court, it should be at least 300. Okay. Number three, there should be enough space given by the LGU or leased from the private sector. Number four, and I have here a letter coming from, a note coming from the prosecutor service, that there should be likewise an accompanying prosecutor that would man the said sala. So for Silang Cavite, are we in that equation? 500 cases for the two salas, meaning to say 1,000 cases immediately that would occupy the docket of the proposed Silang courts, Your Honor.
Thank you, Your Honor. Again, good morning. First, let me just confirm that there is no regional trial court in Silang. And as pointed out by the honorable sponsor, Congressman Loyola, that cases within the jurisdiction of regional trial courts emanating from Silang are actually filed in the regional trial courts of Tagaytay. The 500 cases threshold, Your Honor, is actually for purposes of determining whether or not there is a need to add an additional RTC. So what we will be looking at is the caseload of Tagaytay and not necessarily, Your Honor, how many cases that can be generated, no, from Silang if there will be a regional trial court. Based on our figures, Your Honor, of course, the number of regional trial courts right now in Tagaytay City is about four existing, Your Honor. And many of these courts actually have caseloads over 300, Your Honors. But if we will separate now the cases coming from Silang, it may not reach that many, Your Honor. But we, in the Office of the Court Administrator, support this particular proposal because we believe that it will help provide the judicial service needed by the people of Silang directly, as well as the courts that will, as well as the municipalities that will fall under the jurisdiction of the proposed RTC Silang. At present, Your Honor, there is a first level court, MCTC Silang Amadeo. So what will happen, Your Honor, if that RTC will be created is that all cases coming from Silang and Amadeo within the jurisdiction of a regional trial court can be brought to an RTC silang if this will be approved, Your Honor.
But Your Honor, my records coming from the Supreme Court would reflect that as of April 30, with indulgence of Congressman Loyola, as of April 30, 2023, there were only 143 cases pending.
Yes, that's in MCTC.
MCTC.
Yes, for Your Honor. That's in the MCTC. But like I said, we will have to look into the caseload of Tagaytay, Your Honor, because that's where the jurisdiction of the RTC.
Any objection coming from the court administrator?
None, po, Your Honor, as I mentioned earlier, because we believe this will help provide the needed judicial service for the people of Silang.
What about the ideal ratio of courts per population?
Because we are a total of, I think, 110 million, Your Honor.
For Silang.
For Silang. Yeah. I'm not familiar with the population of Silang, Your Honor, but I know that it's a progressive municipality already. So I think it is well within the range, insofar as population is concerned, for an RTC to be created there, Your Honor.
So with the creation of Silang RTCs, it would remove the backlog of insofar as the RTC of Tagaytay is concerned?
That is correct, Your Honor, because the jurisdiction of RTC Tagaytay includes Silang. And Your Honor, if we may, for the record, in the event that this proposal will be approved, of course, there is a need to provide the whole of justice, as you mentioned, Your Honor, for the RTC of Silang. Or two, if it will be two, Your Honor, it will include an OCC, an Office of the Clerk of Court, that should be provided, Your Honor. And then likewise, Your Honor, the jurisdiction of the RTC Silang, we submit, Your Honor, that this Honorable Committee and Congress would provide as well that the Supreme Court will determine already the areas that will be covered by Silang. This will de-circuitize MCTC Silang and will create another MTC, Your Honor, which is Amadeo.
I will be asking this question for the next for the other similarly situated bills. How much would be the funding requirement needed for the creation of an RTC? Number two, how much would be the funding requirement needed for a lower first level court? Because during our last hearing, it was established for the creation of a division of a court of appeals, it would need 106 million per year, plus. Sa RTC po, magkano ang kakailangan? Kasi ito rin yung itatanong ko dun sa 10 pang sunod-sunod na House bills. Magkano po yung kailangan?
Yes, po. Your Honor, pardon me if I cannot be exact with the figures, Your Honor. But if we're talking about a regional trial court, we talk about personal services first, Your Honor. So it will cover the salaries of the presiding judge, the clerk of court, and then the legal researcher, 4 stenographers, and then 1 sheriff, 2 clerks, docket clerks, 1 process server, and then 1 utility worker, and 1 data entry machine operator, Your Honor. I think roughly that would be like, it would amount to more or less 500 to 600,000 per month, Your Honor. Basic salaries, Your Honor. So if you multiply that by 12, Your Honor, then that would be like perhaps about 6 million in salaries alone, Your Honor. Then with respect to the MOE, Your Honor, then with respect to supplies, the average would be around 2 to 2.5 million, Your Honor, only with respect to basic supplies. But when you talk about security that will be provided, Your Honor, janitorial services.
Electricity, what about electricity, water?
Yes po, that don't be separate, Your Honor, from the 2.5. Siguro baka mabot po ng 3 million po, Your Honor, for MOE, Your Honor.
Per month?
In so far as that...
Parang malaki po ata pag...
Hindi ata per... Baka ho, per annual na po yun.
Annual
na po. Because MOE supply... Yes, annual na po yun. Annual na po. Kasi yung one time naman po yung purchase ng mga supplies, additional na lang based on the need, Your Honors. So, but the security and the janitorial at saka utility, siguro that will more or less 2.5 for MOE, then around siguro mga mga kasi higher po yung sa ano sa mga salaries ng ano po Your Honor, siguro mga 3 million po na additional po for the utilities and some
but sometimes these are shouldered by the host LGU.
When it comes to the RTCs, Your Honors, usually it's shouldered by the Supreme Court. But when it comes to first level court, sometimes it's shouldered by the LGU.
So, still allow the host LGU to shoulder all of this?
No, Your Honor, if they tell us that they cannot afford to provide, Your Honor, we shoulder it immediately, Your Honor, pero using our funds.
Yung LGUs na well-funded, Metro Manila LGUs, pumapayag po kayo?
That's separate, Your Honor. Actually, we cover everything regarding their needs, Your Honors, in Metro Manila because they're near and then very specific naman po yung ano, budget for them. But sometimes the LGUs provide allowances for them, Your Honor, so that's different. That's different. That's what usually comes from the LGU.
So your computation of 500,000 a month, 6 million a year, would still not include the salaries for the prosecutor?
No, Your Honor, because insofar as the prosecutors are concerned, based on their own law, Your Honor, if there is one court that is created, automatic po, two new items for prosecutors will be included no, in their plantilla. So without...
That is not yet funded.
Well, they will have to secure it from Congress, Your Honor, because but the law provides, and there is no need for it to be included, Your Honor, in the law creating courts, yes, because it's automatic in their law, Your Honor. So the only thing that needs to be provided always when creating courts, Your Honor, are the itemized expenses, Your Honors, for personal services such as salaries, benefits, and emoluments. And then for court personal court operations, MOE, and of course the Hall of Justice, Your Honor.
We have a DBM representative here, Department of Budget and Management.
Good morning po, Your Honor.
Can you introduce yourself?
I'm Attorney Tricia Baraan po.
Ay, nakatingin ako sa online. Nandito ka pala, present ka pala.
Yes.
Sorry. Do you confirm the computations made by Justice Villanueva?
Yes, Your Honor, we have a estimated computation po for an RTC single sala court.
Per sala, how much? Kasama na yung kuryente, kasama na yung sweldo,
opo.
Kasama na yung sa prosecutor.
Mga 11.3 million po. Pero tama po kayo, Your Honor, does not include po yung salaries for prosecutors.
11.3 million for the judges alone. The judiciary alone.
Opo.
So if you include the prosecution service, how much would it entail?
I-double check po namin, sir, kasi yun po hindi po namin
na-estimate. So we're looking at a figure of 11.3 million for annually.
Opo.
Rough estimates. So that would be 22.6 million for the two RTC salas of Silang, Cavite.
Yes, Your Honor.
And so on and so forth. So lahat ng pag-uusapan natin ngayon, ganun yung ballpark figure natin. Diba?
Depende po kung ilan po.
Can we have a figure likewise for the prosecution service?
Yes, sir. We will prepare.
Para, hindi, as we go along, habang kasunod na yung ibang mga house bills, para may ballpark figure. Hindi naman siguro ganun kalaki yun, di ba?
Sige po, we'll prepare po.
Sabi ni Justice Villanueva, automatic na raw yun eh. Kayo na magkocompute nun eh.
Yung, kung i-create pa po siya, Your Honor, the same should be reviewed po by DBM. So CIPA or yung concerned office should request po sa DBM for the
DOJ, the Assistant Secretary is here. Magkano ang computation ng prosecution service? Ni PAU pa yan, di ba? May yes, PAU pa yan. May kasama pa yung PAU. So magkano ang computation nyo?
Mr. Chair, I'm getting the information now from personnel and finance. I'll apprise the chairman, sir, as soon as I get the information, sir.
Yung PAU, hindi naman, ilan bang PAU? Bawat isang sala? Isa. So, one PAU and then one fiscal. So can we have that as we go along? Judges Association of the Philippines, any concern concerning relative to the bill filed by Congressman Loyola? Two additional salas for Silang Cavite. New, not additional. RTCs. Any objection? Violent? Event?
Of course, we fully support, Your Honor, the proposal to create various courts, considering it's first-hand information. It's, for example, in Muntinlupa, there is actually a proposal, Your Honor, and so far as Muntinlupa is concerned.
No, we tackle first Silang Cavite. House Bill 6580, creating two additional branches of the Regional Trial Court, the 4th Judicial Region, the Station, the Municipality of Silang.
Well, the Philippine Judges Association, Your Honor, support the proposal to create two branches in Silang, Your Honor.
DBM, ano yung mga hindi mo pwedeng mabigkas dito? Yung sa funding requirements? Meron bang court na dumating, na create na court na napasama sa mga unfunded mandates? Meron na ba sa pag-aaral nyo?
Sir, per our operations group, kahit po unfilled yung positions ng Supreme Court,
unfunded. Creating laws, creating, requiring disbursement of funds but not funded. May figures ganun?
I-double check din po namin, sir. Kasi
sa records ko, meron tayong 163 laws. No funds. 163 laws. Not funded. That's why they were not properly implemented. To name a few, the AFP Modernization Act. Ang kulang na pondo, 297.7 billion. National Electrification Administration Reform Act of 2003, 20 billion ang kulang. Murang Kuryente Act, 184 billion, and so on and so forth. Ang dami, kaya sa Kongreso, ang daming na ipa-file, na-approve, pero hindi naman napondohan. We recognize the arrival of the great chairperson of the Committee on Public Order, Senator Ronald Bato de la Rosa. Sir, ang pinag-uusapan namin yung creation of courts because later on we'll be suspending and then we'll tackle the NBI escapee incident. So, Attorney Tricia, ano yung mga nagawa na batas ng Kongreso, ng Senado, tapos walang pondo, hindi namin ma-implement. Meron ba nangyari na sa courts na kinreate kami tapos walang pondo?
Sir, if I may po.
Yes.
Ang procedure naman po, sir, basta yung Supreme Court will submit po their request for creation of positions, then the DBM will process po. And then, come budget prep, napupondohan na po siya kahit po unfilled positions.
The capital outlay, yung mga courts, yung building.
The same po will go through the usual budget process po.
So, automatic meron?
Opo, basta submitted po ni Supreme Court.
Kasi kailan ang budget call na? Kailan?
Patapos na po yung NEP for 2024.
Aabot ito?
But sir, the Supreme Court can always use their savings po since the Supreme Court is authorized to use their savings.
Justice, so pwede raw gamitin yung savings kung hindi umabot sa budget ito this year. Pasok itong lahat ng itong 11?